If you care about fuel economy at all, and polls show that most Americans do these days, you're tempted to go with a car that gets great fuel economy, and you're tempted to go with a hybrid. You don't have to though, because more and more automakers are bringing diesels to the States. This here is the 2013 Volkswagen Passat TDI, and we're gonna take a closer look at it. This car is a case example of German classical efficiency and simplicity. There's nothing extravagant that you're gonna see on the outside of the car. Yes, it does have some stylish looking headlamps, but the rest is muted lines. It's a good design for someone who's not into something flashy. The lines are there. There's a little bit of a cool cut line in the shoulder. It's got nicely styled wheels, but it's very basic in a good way. We're not saying that as a knock against the car. This reminds us of old school German sedans in the best way possible. The heart of the Passat TDI lies under the hood, just as you'd think it would be. This is a TDI motor, which means it is a turbo diesel. This is a four-cylinder unit, and it's good for 140 horsepower and 236 pound-feet of torque. And that's part of what makes the diesel more engaging to drive than a hybrid. It has low-end grunt. All the power of this engine, you get it at just 1,750 RPM. Now, that power does taper off because it is a diesel, so you'll be shifting early to stay in the power bands, but that's also gonna help you with fuel economy. This is why these are more exciting than hybrids. You've got power and fuel economy. You can have your automotive cake and eat it too. I've mentioned efficiency a couple times when talking about the Passat. What I'm referring to there, besides effective use of design, is effective use of space. The back seat of this car has plenty of legroom. This front seat, the driver's seat, is situated exactly where I'd put it, and I'm 6'3". Now, another 6'3 person behind it, you can tell this car was built for the Germans, because I'm quite comfortable, and they are a tall bunch. Still, they're not going into the trunk here. The trunk is huge, there's plenty of space back here. So you've got good space up front, great space in the back, and plenty of cargo room. That's efficiency. Besides the diesel engine and its torque, the other thing that makes this car surprisingly fun to drive is right here. You can get it with a 6-speed manual gearbox. You can get it with an automatic too, but if you want to extract the most from the engine and get the most enthusiast bang for your green buck, right here, manual gearbox, thumbs up. So the real thrill of driving the Passat TDI doesn't come from the overall driving experience. Yes, it does appeal to enthusiasts, but the real thrill you get is when you see how well you're doing in the fuel economy department. This car is rated to hit 43 miles per gallon on the highway and around 35 miles per gallon city. Now, we're not driving it super laid back like the EPA would. We're having fun with the car because it's got a manual gearbox and it's got over 200 pound-feet of torque. We're doing about 34, 35 miles per gallon in combined driving. We're pretty happy with that too because that's a great number. We've put over 250 miles on the car and we've still got plenty of fuel left. That's why this car is great. Because it's not a boring hybrid, you're gonna actually be able to enjoy yourself and get the good fuel economy. This is the best of both worlds. It's not all lovely though, from an enthusiast driving standpoint. There are a few things that remind you that this is definitely not a sports car, and we have no belief that it actually is that. It's just a fun to drive diesel. Our example here is the clutch. Volkswagen has been having trouble with some of their clutches, and there's still no feel with this clutch. The shifter is better than Volkswagen shifters of past. They're getting a little bit more notchy, and we mean that in a good way, that there's some actual feel heel, and it's not like stirring a bowl of spaghetti. The clutch, though, there's still no feel there. We wish it was a little bit better. But besides that, the brakes are good, the handling's fine, the interior is well refined. Even though this is a base low trim SE model, you still get a nice radio system here with touch screen buttons. You can pair your phone via Bluetooth very quickly, I might add. We did it at a stoplight before the light turned green. Phone was snapped in there, ready to go. So there's a little bit of good and bad inside the cabin, but it's mostly good, and that means it's a good car. So what does it cost to get into the Passat TDI? Well, this car is $27,000. Under $30,000 for a car like this is a great price point. Sure, if you want navigation, if you want a few extra goodies, you're gonna have to spend for it. It's very easy to push this car into the mid $30,000 range, probably tickling $40,000. But as this car sits at $27,000, it's a great value proposition.